Well, a very warm welcome to our first Toddler Hub and Mini Melodies Online. And you're very welcome to join in and watch what we're doing today. We're going to be doing some singing, then we're going to have a story, and today's story is Goldilocks and the Three Bears. And then we're going to show you a craft activity which you can do at home, and we'll look forward very much to when we can all be together again. So I'm going to hand over to Tom now to start our songs about noises.
Fantastic, thank you Marilyn, and welcome to our mini melodies session today. We're going to be singing some of our favourite songs that we've already started singing, all about the noises all around us and all about some of the Bible stories in the Old Testament with noises. But we're going to start off with our hello song. Marilyn's here on the piano and Hazel's going to join us in a little bit as well. Let's get ready to give everyone a big wave hello. Hello all the boys, hello all the boys, hello all the boys, it's good to see you here. Now the girls, hello all the girls, hello all the girls, hello all the girls, it's good to see you here. Now the grown-ups, hello grown-ups, hello grown-ups, hello grown-ups, it's good to see you here. And give yourselves a big clap. Well done. Now, can you see here? I've got one of our music bags for Mini Melodies. I've got some nice things inside here. I've got a shaker. I've got some tapping sticks. I love the noise that they make. I've got some bells as well, which I can ring. Can you hear those? And I've also got a nice floaty scarf for when we have a dance time later on. I wonder what things you've got in your house that make a noise. Maybe you could have a look around with your grown-ups and maybe look for some spoons. They would make some really nice tapping sticks, wouldn't they? Or if you found a saucepan, you could make it into a drum as well. I wonder what things you're going to find for your in your house or your home to play today. Well, we're going to sing about this music bag, and we're going to sing about the bells with the music bag song. It's the music bag, it's the music bag. What shall we play today? We will play the bells. We will play the bells. That's what we'll play today. Now let's play it with something that you found at home. And you may need to just pause the video whilst you're looking for those things. Okay, let's give it a go. It's the music bag, it's the music bag. What shall we play today? We will play the, that's what we'll play today. And see if you can give your instruments a really loud shake or a bang and make a great noise. Well done. Give yourselves a really big clap again. Ooh. Can you hear that sound? Can you hear the ringing noise? That sounds a bit like the church bells here. And it reminds me of a song called Faire Jacques, which is actually in French, so that's all a bit clever. We're doing a French song today called Faire Jacques. Let's give this one a go, shall we? Faire Jacques, Faire Jacques, dormez-vous, solemne natina, ding dang dong, let's do it again and see if you can join in, especially with the ding dang dong bit. Faire Jacques, dormez vous, solemne natina, ding dang dong, well done, that was fantastic. We're going to think now about the noises that we can make with a really good song about what noise we can make to say that God is great. And you can do some actions with a big thumbs up for making a great noise. What noise shall we make to say that God is great? What noise shall we make unto the Lord? Let's make a loud noise to say that God is great. Let's make a loud noise unto the Lord. Can you make your loud noise? Here is my loud noise. Here is my loud noise. Here is my loud noise unto the Lord. What noise shall we make to say that God is great? What noise shall we make unto the Lord? Let's make a quiet noise to say that God is great. Let's make a quiet noise unto the Lord. Can you make your quiet noise? Here is my quiet noise. Here is my quiet noise. Here is my quiet noise unto the Lord. We like making noise to say that God is great. We like making noise unto the Lord. And give yourselves a really big clap at home. Well, I've got a poem now, which is all about noises. It's called The Noisy Day by Shel Silverstein. Let's have one day for girls and boys when you can make the grandest noise. Screech and scream and holler and yell, buzzer, buzzer and clang a bell. Sneeze, hiccup, whistle, shout, laugh until your lungs wear out. Toot a whistle, kick a can, bang a spoon against a pan. Sing and yodel, bellow, hum, blow a horn and beat a drum. And maybe if you've got a saucepan, you can make a nice drum sound now by hitting that. And give yourselves another big clap. Well, we're going to tell a story now all about a baby boy called Moses. And I need you to help by making some of the sound effects at home. And I've got my very special buttons here. Can you see them? I've got a pink button. I've got a green button. And I've got a blue button. I'm going to use the pink button first, and that's going to help us for the first verse when we think about baby Moses. So this button will go shh, and I hope you can go shh at home as well. These buttons didn't really work properly last week, so hopefully it will work this time. One, two, three. Oh, that wasn't the right noise, was it? Let me see if I can just tweak it around. Here we go. One, two, three. Oh dear, that's the wrong noise as well. I know. Maybe if all of you at home, can you all make the noise so it knows what to do? All of you go shh. Fantastic. Let's see if it works now. One, two, three. Shh. Oh, brilliant. Thank you very much for getting the first button to work. So the first verse, we need to say shh. Then the second verse, we've got the bit of a burning noise as Moses sees a bush, which looks like it's burning because it's on fire, but actually the bush stays okay. So that's going to be the green button, so we need to make a bit of a whoosh noise. Can you do that at home? Let's see if the button knows what noise you're making. One, two, three. Oh no, you need to be louder at home. Can you make the nice whooshy noise at home? One, two, three. Perfect, so we've got the working, and we've got the fire. Brilliant. Now we've got the blue button, and this one is going to need to make a nice walking noise. Okay, so can you make a walking noise at home? Let's see if it works. Oh dear, that's not right. That's still not right. Maybe we need to do some more walking at home. Make it really loud so we can hear your footprints, and so the button knows what to do. One, two, three. Perfect. Well done. Give yourselves a bit of a clap. So, shall we sing the song now? This is all about Moses in the basket to start with. Okay? Moses in a basket floating on the water. Someone came and found him. It was the king's daughter. Little baby Moses grew up big and strong, but he had to run away when he did something wrong. Oh no. So then Moses grew up and he went to the desert. And this is where you need to make the whoosh sound, okay? Can you give that a go? You go whoosh. Well done. Moses in the desert with his sheep and goats saw a bush of fire, listened when God spoke. To Egypt you must go, listen to me now, and tell the king of Egypt he must let my people go. Wow, so Moses was being given a really important job there. He had to go and speak to the king. Then, the last verse, I need Moses' big stick, which he used for going walking with. So can we do our walking sounds? Fantastic. God's people all went travelling to a brand new land, hungry, tired and thirsty, walking in the sand. God sent food from heaven, manna they could eat. When Moses hit the rock, clean water came out clean and sweet. Wow. So God used Moses to do some amazing things, didn't he? Well, to help us to think a bit more about what Moses did, we could think about the time that he helped all of the people go to freedom when the Red Sea opened up and all the people could run through it without getting wet. And so Marilyn is going to be our key person for this one, because Marilyn is going to play some music on the piano. When she plays the quiet music, we'll all be nice and quiet and nice and still at home. But then when she plays the really fast music, it'll be time for us to run through the Red Sea. We can run on the spot, or if we've got space in our rooms, to run around the rooms carefully as we imagine running through the Red Sea. Let's give this one a go, shall we? Let's listen to the piano. Now let's go running and going through the Red Sea and imagining how special that must have felt. I'm sure there's some brilliant running going on at home. Well done. It's keeping me warmed out, certainly. Fantastic. Do you think we get to do that one more time? Really quiet. Give yourselves a really big clap. Well done. You've done such a good job there of helping us to remind ourselves all about the story of Moses. And now we're going to find out about someone else in the Old Testament, someone who was called Joshua.
This is a story about a man called Joshua who made a great big noise with his friends until all the walls of the city came tumbling down. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho and the walls came tumbling down. They played their trumpets around the walls, they played them round the town. They jumped and prayed and sang and danced till the walls came tumbling down. Oh, Joshua fought the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho till the walls came tumbling down.
Ah, thank you very much, Hazel. That was a fantastic song about how Joshua was used by God. And now we're going to be thinking about some other songs that are in the Bible written to God, or written about God, or written to tell God about the way that people were feeling. This is Psalm number 100, and we've put a nice little tune to it and just changed the words a little bit so we can really understand them. So Hazel's going to play on her guitar and I'm going to sing along to this one. And at home, you could all try and do the actions, especially doing some singing, doing some praising, and saying thank you. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, everyone. Serve the Lord and sing to him, everyone. God made us and cares for us every day, just like a shepherd with his sheep does every day. So come and sing your songs to him, everyone, making lots of praising sounds, everyone. Say thank you to God who's good every day. He's always with us in every way, every day. Fantastic. That was brilliant, wasn't it? Did you hear in that psalm how God was described as being like a shepherd? And a shepherd looks after sheep, just like God looks after people. And so I'm just trying to think if I can remember any of my favourite songs about sheep. Can you remember any favourite songs about sheep? I wonder, Marilyn, can you remember any favourite songs about sheep? What are you thinking of? Bar Bar Black Sheep. What a great song to sing. Let's give Bar Bar Black Sheep a bit of a go, shall we? Bar Bar Black Sheep, have you any wool? Yes, sir, three bags full. One for the master and one for the dame, and one for the little boy who lives down the lane. Thank you, said the master, thank you, said the dame, thank you, said the little boy who lives down the lane. Fantastic. Well, now we've got one more song to sing and then one song to dance to. Now we're going to sing The Music Man. Who knows this one? Do you know the song The Music Man? And I'm going to sing about a couple of the things I've got in my music bag, but you can always sing with the things that you've got in your music kits at home that you've made today. So I'm going to sing about the tapping sticks today, and I'm going to sing about the bells. Let's give this one a go. I am the music man, and I come from down your way, and I can play. What can I play? I play the tapping sticks. Tap, 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 tap. I am the music man, and I come from down your way, and I can play. Yes, I can play. I play the bells. Ring-a-ling-a-ding-a-ding, ding-a-ding, ding-a-ding. Ring-a-ring-a-ding-a-ding, ring-ring-ding-ding-ding. Fantastic, and well done for joining in so well at home as well. Give yourselves a bit of a clap. Wow, I wonder what noises you've heard today. If it's getting a bit later, if you've not eaten for a while, maybe you hear the noise of a rumble in your tummy. So I'd love it if you can find some floaty material. I've got a scarf here. You could maybe use a tea towel if you've got one at home, or a cloth maybe, or maybe you've got a scarf that you can use. And we're going to have a bit of a dance to a song by Winnie the Pooh all about his rumbly tumbly. See if you can do some dancing to this one.
Hum-da-dee-dum, hum-da-dee-dum, I'm so rumbly.
Maybe you could rub your tummy to say that you've got a rumbly tumbly.
Early lunch, hum-da-dee-dum-dum.
What else you can do? We do some stretches today.
If a poo flew like a bee.
Fantastic. Don't forget to wave your floaty material around.
So I guess I wouldn't care then.
Bears, maybe you can try and dance like a bear. What do they do? Do you think they plod a bit like that? Who can do some plodding at home?
In my tumbly, time for something sweet.
What do you think Winnie the Pooh wants to eat then, if he's feeling really hungry? Maybe we could do some looking for some food. Do some more looking around to find some food. I think he's going to look for some honey. Let's do some dancing.
Climb this tree if a pool flew like a bee. But I wouldn't be a bear then, so I guess I wouldn't care.
Let's do some more bear stomping.
Bears love honey and I'm a poo bear, so I do care, so I'll climb there. I'm so rumbly in my tumbly, a time for something sweet.
And give yourselves a really big clap. That was a great song to finish our session of mini melodies with. But do stay on, because we've got some craft coming up and we've got a story time. But before then, I need you to make a bit of a drum roll on your knees. And well done, because we've got the notices. And we've not got lots of notices today, so it'll be nice and quick. But just a reminder that if you want to get in contact with us, all of our contact details are just on the bottom of the screen now. If there's any way we can help during this lockdown, or any questions you've got, please do send us a message, either to the Tom at St James email address or the Hello at St James email address. And I'm going to be off on leave for some of this time, so if you can't get hold of me, use the Hello message one and someone will get back to you as soon as possible. And over the next few weeks, we'll also give you details about some of the special events we've got planned for Christmas after lockdown has finished. But I'm going to hand over now as we move on to our story time.
Hello, my name is Sandra and this is Beatrice. And we are here today.
Name Beatrice.
You're going to say your name. What's your name?
Beatrice. My name is Beatrice.
And today we are going to tell you our story, which is the story of Goldilocks and the three bears. Once upon a time, three bears lived in the cottage. A big bear, a medium-sized bear, and a small bear. They decided one morning to have porridge for their breakfast. So they made the porridge, but it was much too hot. So after a little bit of a chat, they decided to go for a walk in the woods. The bears were out having their walk. A little girl named Goldilocks came across their house in the woods. After a little bit of thinking, she decided to go inside. And on the table, she found three bowls of porridge. The first bowl was the biggest bowl, and it was far too hot. The medium-sized bowl was too cold, but the little bowl was just right.
Yum 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 yum.
After eating all that porridge, she felt very tired and went into the lounge to see if she could find somewhere to have a rest. First she found a big chair, but it was far too hard. Then she found a medium-sized chair, but it was much too soft. Then she found a little chair that was just right. So she sat there for a while. After sitting for a while, Goldilocks decided that she was far too tired. So she went upstairs and had a look in the bedrooms. The first bed she came to was a very big bed and it was much too hard. The second bed she came to was a medium-sized bed and it was far too soft. The final bed she came to was a small bed and that was just right. So she laid down and had a little sleep. Just then, the bears came back from their walk in the woods and were most surprised to see that somebody had been eating all of their porridge from their bowls. The big bear said, "Somebody's been eating my porridge." The medium bear said, "Somebody's been eating my porridge." And the little bear said, "Somebody's been eating my porridge and they've eaten it all up." Then the bears came to their sitting room. The big bear said, "Somebody's been sitting on my chair." The medium-sized bear said,
"Somebody's been sitting on my chair."
And the little bear said, Somebody's been sitting on my chair as well. Then the bears went upstairs. The biggest bear said, somebody's been sleeping on my bed. The medium bear said, somebody's been sleeping on my bed.
And the baby bear said, somebody's been sleeping on my chair.
and who's asleep on the bed, Bee?
Goldilocks.
Goldilocks. Goldilocks woke up very surprised to see three bears around her. And she ran out of the house all the way back to her mum. And the three bears made their porridge again and ate some yummy porridge together for breakfast.
Yum, 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 yum.
We hope that you enjoyed the story and we look forward to seeing you again next week. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Good morning, everyone. And following on from our story this morning about Goldilocks and the three bears, we have a craft activity now that we can do, which you might like to do at home with your parent or carer. So I've prepared some little bears. We've got Daddy Bear, we've got Mummy Bear, and we have Baby Bear, along with an outline of Goldilocks. Now, what we can do with these is to colour them in. So here's Mummy Bear coloured in, and we have Baby Bear coloured in, and not forgetting, of course, Daddy Bear. Now, to make them look a little bit different, so they're not all the same, I've made a little bib for Baby Bear, an apron for Mummy Bear, and for Daddy Bear, he has a tie. So we would need to put these on with some Prit Stick. So if we take our Prit Stick and carefully put some glue on the back, then we can stick them in place on our bears that we've coloured in. And they'll begin to look like real little people now and ready to be able to retell the story, if you'd like to, by putting some lolly sticks on the back. But first, we'll finish Goldilocks. So here's Goldilocks. I've coloured in her hair, but she hasn't got a very happy smile, has she? So we'll put a smile on Goldilocks with a red pen or a crayon, so she looks really happy to be with the bears. So here she is, all happy and smiley. And you can either colour it in with a dress, or, like I've done, you could cut her out a little dress made of material. And we can put some glue onto Goldilocks, and we can give her a very smart, very pretty pink flowery dress to wear. So we'll put that on here, press it down so she looks all very smart, and she can't go out without any shoes on, so I've made her some little pink boots to match. So you can cut those out. I'm sure you'll have lots of help with the scissors because we have to be very careful, and place them on the bottom so that she's got some smart new boots to wear. So there she is, all ready to go out. On the back of each of these, so that you can make them move a lot easier, I've got some lolly sticks. But if you haven't got lolly sticks, it's not a problem. You can use a piece of cereal packet like I have here, and you could cut some strips because it makes it nice and strong if it's cardboard, and you can place them on the back. Now, I've put on these some little sticky tabs, but we can also use sellotape. So it doesn't matter if you haven't got the tabs or you haven't got the lolly sticks, you can use something else which will make them stick on the back. So I'm going to turn Daddy Bear over, and I'm going to take the sticky tab off, like that, and I'm going to stick it on the bottom, like that, And there we have Daddy Bear ready to be able to be used to retell your story. So we'll get Mummy Bear ready now, but this time, instead of using a sticky tab, I'm going to use some sellotape just to show you that you can use that instead. So we'll put this on the back of Mummy Bear, and I've got some sellotape here on what they call a sellotape dispenser, but you can also use scissors to cut your sellotape with the help of a grown-up. And we can put this across here like this and stick it down, and it works just the same. So Mummy Bear has now got a little stick on her too. So we'll put another stick with sellotape on the back of Baby Bear. So there's Baby Bear with his stick on as well. And last but not least, we'll do Goldilocks. And Goldilocks, I've put another little sticky tab on. I'm going to tear that one off the back. And we'll stick that one on Goldilocks. So now we have Goldilocks and Baby Bear and Mummy Bear and Daddy Bear. And you'll be able to retell the story of Goldilocks using your little puppets to do so. I hope you have lots of fun making these. So enjoy and see you again soon. Bye.
Well, I hope you've had lots of fun listening to the songs and making your craft and listening to the story. And that's all we've got time for today. And we'll look forward to seeing you again online next week. Bye-bye.